गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू रिवाइज द लेसन फ्रॉम सिविक्स इलेक्शन पॉलिटिकल पार्टीज एंड प्रेशर ग्रुप्स इन दिस लेसन ऑलरेडी वी डिस्कस अबाउट द इलेक्टोरल सिस्टम एंड व्हाट आर द मीनिंग्स एंड व्हाट आर द टाइप्स ऑफ पॉलिटिकल सिस्टम एंड पॉलिटिकल पार्टीज एंड व्हाट आर द फंक्शंस एंड व्हाट आर द नेशनल पार्टी एंड रीजनल पार्टीज सो दीज आर द थिंग्स वी डिस्कस्ड Already today we are going to discuss the same lesson and revising this lesson for our terminal examination. So here that the electoral system in India. First one, the electoral system. So our electoral system is followed the United Kingdom. So presently we are following the electoral system. That system was already practiced in the United Kingdom. That means in Britain. India is a socialist, secular, democratic republic and the largest democracy in the world. So India is one of the country, largest democratic country. It has a socialist, secular, democratic republic. Here, the modern India, the constitution of India came into force on 26th January 1950. So our government is running based on the constitution. So our constitution is one of the unique one. So our constitution came into force on the 26th January and 1950, that day we are celebrating every year Republic Day. So here are the article 324 to 329. In part 15 of the constitution, make the following provisions with regard to the electoral system in our country. So our constitution given the rights and given the recognition to the election, to conduct the election. So here that articles are given. Article 324 to 329 dealt about the provisions of electoral system in our country. And here also that the election processes. So election processes at the national level, the head of government, the prime minister is elected by member of the Lok Sabha, the lower of the parliament in India. So here the electoral processes. The central government, that means the head of the government, is in the New Delhi. The prime minister is head of the government. So he is elected by the member of the Lok Sabha. So member of the Lok Sabha means the Lok Sabha election, lower house, upper house election. It is called lower house election is called Lok Sabha election. The Lok Sabha election members elected the prime minister. And another one, the introduction of the nota option. So here the none of the above, that is the option is given, introduced in the 1961, the rule 49O, the conduct of election rules. So on the based on the rules, election rules of the 1961, the nota was introduced. Nota means none of the above. If you didn't want to elect any person, you can select the nota. That is called the none of the above. அப்படின்னு சொன்னால் நான் ஓட்டு போடுறதுக்கு யாருக்கும் எனக்கு ஓட்டு போட விருப்பம் இல்லை, அதனால் நான் என்னுடைய ஓட்டை நோட்டாவில் போடுறேன் அப்படின்னு சொல்லிட்டு நம்ம என்ன செய்யலாம், அங்கே நோட்டா பட்டனை ப்ரெஸ் பண்ணிக்கலாம். The voters verified paper audit trail, that is called VVPAT, is the way forward to enhance the credibility and transparency of the election process. The system was first introduced in 2014 general election in India. Nota was first introduced in the general election held in 2014. India is the 14th country in the world to introduce nota. So India is the 14th country it introduced the nota in the world. So here we can discuss about the types of elections in India. There are two types of election, direct election and indirect election. The direct Lok Sabha election is called a direct election, so and Rajya Sabha election is indirect election. We already discussed about the merits and the demerits of the election. And another one is the political party. So meaning of political party, what is a political party? A political party is an organization formed by a group of people with a certain ideology and agenda to contest election and hold power in the government, that is called a political party. A political party has the three components. Already we know that the three components of the political party: leader, active members and the followers. So these are the
components of political party. Yeah, the types of party system in India. So in India, multi-party system was followed. The presently we are following the multi-party system, but there are three types of party system in the world: single party, two party or bi-party system, and multi-party system. In the single party system, in which one ruling party exists and no opposition party. Here, China, Cuba, the former USSR are the example for the single party system. In the single party system, only one party exists, no opposition party is permitted. The bi-party or two-party system, in which only two major parties exist, for example UK and USA. In the multi-party system, there are more than two political parties, for example India, Sri Lanka, France and Italy. So these are called multi-party system. The types of political party. In this types of political party, there are two types of political party. One is a national party, another one is a regional party. So here, national party, ruling opposition, state party, ruling opposition. The same features in the state and central. So here, what is called a national party? A party which is recognized as a state party in at least four states is recognized as a national party. Every party in the country has to register with the election commission, while the commission treats all the parties equally. So that is called election party. State party here. So state party, it at least got four states. There are common referred as a regional party here. The role of opposition party also we discussed. And another one is the pressure group. A large number of, we are called the pressure groups. You can see here, the pressure groups in India. A large number of pressure groups exist in India, but they are not developed to the same extent as in the USA or the Western countries like Britain, France, Germany and so on. But in India, the pressure groups are also there, but there is no same extent like in the USA or other countries of Western Europe. The pressure groups here: influence, response of business, criticism, effects. So the pressure groups. The pressure groups in India can be broadly classified into following categories. First one is the business groups. Second one is the trade unions, agrarian groups, professional associations, student organizations, religious organizations, tribal organizations, linguistic groups, ideology based groups, environmental protection groups. These are called pressure groups in India. So here, the mobilization people towards the socially protective activity and lead to the overall betterment of people lives in essential. That means here, the people participation should be important in the social activities or in the some natural calamities. So like earthquake, tsunami, flood and other such natural calamities. The masses can occur and the people's immediate mobilization for evacuation and emergency relief become most essential. So this here, the evacuation area or in the evacuation or the natural calamities, the people should be mobilized from one place to, that means from hazardous zones to the safer zone. So okay children, we will see the map. So here is a map, world map. In the world map you can see the civilizations of the world. So four civilization, major four civilizations are given. So you can find out this civilization in your map. And it is very very important. So Egyptian civilization began in the Nile River Valley, and then Mesopotamian civilization is here, Indus civilization is here, Chinese civilization is here. So it's very very important. These four civilizations were called early civilizations. And also we are going to see next one is
the Chinese civilization.
There is a Chinese civilization where the two rivers, Huang here, that means Yellow River, and this civilization began in the Yellow River. So this is a Yellow Sea, East China Sea also. So, and this is the Gobi Desert, Cold Desert, and this is Himalaya, and these are the regions of the Chinese civilization.
So the Indus Valley civilization, there is a Iran, Afghanistan and Pakistan. So here there is the river that is called the Indus River. The number of cities and sites of Indus sites are located in the Pakistan, and some of the regions only is in India. So here the Mohenjo-daro, Ganveriwala and Ratgirhi and Harappa, these are the Indus civilizations. So these are the maps, are very very important maps. So study it and practice it very carefully, get good marks. Thank you.